welcome to Morning Manners. This morning we are broadcasting from inside a pink, but not any pink, the newest pink in the land. And that newest pink is on the Northern Highway. To tell us a little bit about pink and what's been going on, we have Cindy Katus. Cindy, good morning. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you for having me. As you know, this pink boutique has been open for a couple weeks now, but we already are starting with some sales. Since we've offered, every time we offer our sales, we have it in all the pink stores most of the time. So since we had our recent sale, which is a big mega sale, we have 10%, 15%, 20%, 30%, and 50% off in all the stores. That's the one in San Pedro, in Cayo, Belize City, and here on the Northern Highway. So I guess you're not gonna, maybe later on you can get a little picture of it, of all the racks that we have in here that has all the sales available.
You know, Cindy, not because I sit here and I say this the last time when I was in one of your stores, I like coming to pink because I like simplicity. I like when I walk in, I can find something and I don't have to go all over the place. When I come into pink, I can find something for the office, as you can see. Oops, there, including the shoes. And then I can find something for the beach. I am a romper queen. All my friends will tell you that I am the queen of rompers. So when you see me in a romper, you know that I feel fully dressed. It's one piece of clothes,
yeah,
and that's it. I don't have to look for one bottom to match, one top to match, everything match immediately because it comes matching. And you can also find that at Pink Boutique. What I like about this Pink Boutique is that I live in Leederville.
Oh, okay.
So I don't have to fight up with the traffic. Yeah. I don't have to figure out where I'm parking the right side of the street.
If not, we have a parking lot too. Next to the store right here, we have a parking lot. If you can't find any parking in front of the store. But there's normally a lot of parking here.
Excellent. Why should people choose pink?
Because we have a little bit of something for everybody. We have for the person that wants to dress more conservatively. We also have for people that might want to be a little bit more risky and, you know, be more out there showing off their bodies. But, of course, in a classy way. We try to keep everything a little bit classy. And like you said, we have lots of rompers. So we're probably the best place to get rompers. And I know exactly why you like rompers. It's because you like comfy. But you could find a lot of things here that's both comfy and stylish. And that's also why I like Pink Boutique.
You know, most of the time when you see me sitting on this set, I am wearing something from Pink Boutique. Today is no different. I put on a dress today. I put on a red dress today because I figure I need to stand out. I know Cindy's skinny and pretty, so I have to put something that will compete with that, right? And I think I did a pretty decent job this morning. I gave it a shot, didn't I?
You look amazing. You look great. I love it. You definitely the outshine me.
I don't know about all that. You got youth by your side. You got size by your side. You have all sorts of things on your side. But this is one of the things that I also like about pink, is that people from different age group and size can find something in here. Both of us shopped at pink today.
Yes.
And you are must be a size 0 or a size 1 or a size minus or something like that.
This is actually a size medium.
That no medium. My old size them a medium and I ain't never been that size.
I normally wear small though. This one just probably ran a little bit small.
Excellent. So whenever you are passing here on the Northern Highway, stop in that pink. There's something in here for you. And not only is there something in here for you, there is something in here for you on sale. Because that's where I normally start my shopping, in any store I go. Call me what you want. I start on the sale rack. The sale rack just means that they're trying to get rid of it a little bit faster. At least I think so. And I'm willing to help them get rid of it a little faster by buying it.
I shop sale too. I shop sale a lot.
Tell us a little bit about your bag selection. Because, you know, everybody wants a nice shoe and they want a nice dress. But a lot of my friends, like myself, we're looking for good bags.
Actually, bags are something that you can use as a statement. Sometimes you find the right bag and it's just amazing and you must have it, but you don't know what you're gonna wear it with. And then the bag ends up becoming the thing that you have to wear this one time. So you're finding the entire outfit to go with the bag instead of the other way around. So we definitely have a bunch of bags like that. We have some statement pieces, and we have, you know, the regular priced bags. And then we also have designer handbags here too. We carry Michael Kors and Kate Spade bags are here. They're all original. And we also have some Italian-made leather handbags here too. And that's a feature that you can't find in the other Pink stores. The other Pink stores will have, you know, our regular line of bags that we carry. A lot of them right now are sets, and I think that's just the best thing. You get a small one, you get the big one that you can carry everything in, and then you get the little smaller one for maybe you're not carrying around that much today, or maybe you just want to carry everything but you want a more organized way of doing it, so you have smaller little purses inside of the bigger ones, and I like that.
If Grover would have passed me my bag, then I'd tell you how my bag hung. Greg, pass me my bag over there, man. Don't be shy about it. I don't want the people to see what the inside of the bag now, because that would be the secret stand. But you see this bag? I got this bag right here, pink, right? And inside of this bag, thank you, Greg. Another one thing with Greg, you know, Greg come to work for work. No mess with Greg. Inside of that bag, have another bag that slings across my shoulder. Mm-hmm. The kind of bag that I like to go out on a weekend, because when I go out on a weekend, I need the hands. You know, when I do like this, I need my hands.
And you don't have to worry about where did I leave my bag? Did I leave it? And then all my phone, my card, my money, everything is in there.
Yeah. And I got that bag set for maybe about $45 or $50 for that, for them two bags. And two on the neck out of some nice soft leathery material. Mm-hmm. And the sling cross it just absolutely fashionable. If I could find a picture of it, I might put it up. If I can't, well, until I wear it again, one of you see me on the street and you say, ah, that the bag you get a pink. Tell us. So you have these sales going on in all the Pink stores simultaneously, all the time. What separates this store on the Northern Highway from the other stores?
Well, like I was saying, we do have designer handbags here. We have a few other products that are exclusive for this Pink boutique. We also have Pink Princesses right behind you over there. So this is the only store that carries clothing, shoes, accessories, and little gift items for little princesses, your little princesses that you might be dressing up with you. So this is the only store you can get that, and also the handbags, the resort wear. We also have resort wear here as well. We don't have that really in other Pink stores. And we have some beauty products and cosmetics here that you can't find in the other stores as well.
So whenever you're going home, Ladyville, Orangewa, Corozal, Bellama, any of the Bellamas, you have to pass here. And if you have to pass here, you need to stop in here. And even if you don't live up this side, sometimes you come out of the city, mm-hmm. come out of the heat of the city, and have a look up here, you know, I mean, oh, this is one of the, I know I'm going on, and we're going to break this segment soon, but one of the things that I like about Pink as well, is that if I come in here, like last week I came in here, I was looking for this specific item. I can't tell you what it is. Okay? Because you will know. And I don't want you to think that I'm wearing it today. And since I'm not wearing it today, I don't want to tell you. So I was looking for one specific item. And they only had small and medium up here. I need a medium large, okay? Mm. Of this item.
Yes.
I don't even know why they make this item small. Because it's small. People don't need this item.
I think you'd give her too much information about the item. Everybody don't know what the item is.
Oh, no, act like you don't know, you hear me? But the good thing with this Pink is that they will call downtown, they will call San Pedro, they will call wherever they need to call to see if any of the other Pink stores have it. Because if I can't get it here, then they could possibly send it here for me. If I pay for it, they could send it to my house.
We actually do that in all the stores. If you want something and it's not available there in your size, just ask the cashier or the manager if they can check with the other stores to see if they have it and if they can get it to you in.
That way you don't have to run all around town to get it. You just have to come to one store, pay for it, and before you know it, boom, you have it. Anything you'd like to leave our audience with where Pink is concerned?
A lot of people don't know that we also do online deposit sales. So that's also a thing. If you go on our page and you see something that you might like and you would like to have it shipped to you because maybe a Pink boutique doesn't exist where you live, like Corozal or Dandriga or Pasente, wherever, we do offer deposit sales as well. We arrange everything in inbox.
Well, you know, Cindy, before we go, since you think the people know what it is that I was thinking about, I am sure they don't. But if there is somebody out there that can guess the item that I was looking for that I couldn't find in my size because I just couldn't. All the people my size don't buy them out already. But they have in medium, small, and they have in large, and they have in double extra large. But they don't have none right now in medium large. But if you can guess what that item is, you can win yourself that item. The first person to send a text to the number on the screen, 602-2066, and tell me what the item is. Once you tell me what the item is and you win, then I will, only then I will ask you for your name. So if you can, you can start the guessing. So you would send a text and you would say X, and I'd say I wouldn't answer it. But at the end of the day, if you tell me what the item is, I will tell you that you're the lucky winner, and you can pick one up at any of the pink outlets in this country. On that note, we're going to take a break and be back.
Taste of pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
100% pure and natural. Share the juice with your family and your neighbors. And you can find them in so many flavors.
Like grapefruit, orange,
hey!
Orange, pineapple, fruit punch, apple,
hey!
And pineapple.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
100% pure and natural.
No preservatives, no additives. Pure fresh orange, that is how real it is.
Buy one, open it, and drink it. So nice.
Gimme, the Caribbean pride.
100% pure and natural.
Of all the colors in the world, orange is perhaps the most exciting, distinctive, and vibrant color there is. Just like the Orange Gallery. But what makes the Orange Gallery outstanding is what's inside. A huge collection of breathtaking wood carvings and a spectacular display of home decor accessories and magnificent gift items. Browse a fabulous selection of furniture from chairs to entertainment centers. And wait till you see the Orange Gallery's breathtaking selection of jewelry for every occasion and every person, from casual to dressy bracelets and earrings to great items for men, including a spectacular choice of handmade knives. Then, when you've shopped till you're ready to drop, drop in to the Orange Gallery's fabulous restaurant and recharge for the rest of your orange expedition. The Orange Gallery. Beautiful. Unique. Exquisite.
Have an idea for the building of a structure and not sure exactly what you want or how to go about achieving it? Then worry no more. Let the pros at Remen Associates get it done for you. At Remen Associates, we have trained professionals that can assist you in the designing, engineering, and construction of the building of your choice. At Remen Associates, we bring your ideas to life. Call Remen Associates at 615-6200 or visit them at 3/4 miles on the Iguana Creek Road in the Spanish Lookout.
Si tu perro es de raza, raza grande o pequeña, dale Rambocan, Rambocan.
Si es delgado o robusto, pelo largo, pelo corto,
dale Rambocan, Rambocan.
Rambocan en su presentación
para adultos
o cachorros.
Dale Rambocan
para que tu perro tenga piel sana y pelo brillante, huesos y dientes fuertes, músculos resistentes y mejor digestión. Dale lo mejor.
Dale Rambocan.
Salud y vigor para tu perro.
Looking for quality and affordable fashion? The It Store, where you can shop fashion for less. We have clothing for the entire family and quality that fits your budget. The number one store in town. Find kids, men, and women apparel for all occasions. We are located at the number one Queen Street, Belize City. Call us at 223-1552. Remember to like us on Facebook. The It Store. Find it, love it, buy it for less.
At West Track Belize City, we are looking to help you save both your time and money. We've also improved our stock levels to ensure we have everything you might need for your automotive or agricultural needs. Additionally, West Track has added heavy-duty and industrial parts to keep your trucks and equipment running. At West Track Belize City, we understand that your time is important, so we want to bring our services to you at your convenience. Now you can simply send us a message on WhatsApp or Facebook, and we will be right there to help with any questions you may have.
Hello and welcome to A&R.
With a wide variety of household items, party supplies, and gift ideas to choose from,
A&R is definitely the shopping spot of choice for you. We have loads of kitchen appliances such as freezers, washers, refrigerators, pots, pans, and other items including stationery, school bags, swimming pools, sturdy plastic chairs, and toys for boys and girls. Check out A&R at any of our many locations in San Pedro, Orange Walk, Cayo, and Belize City. At A&R, we strive to provide all your shopping needs under one roof.
Second portion of For Morning Manners right here at Pink Boutique on the Northern Highway. This is the newest Pink and you must stop in. Right? If you get the opportunity, stop in. If you can't stop in today, stop in tomorrow. Stop in whenever you can. Because I have to remind you that there's always a sale going on in here. And when there's a sale, that doesn't mean the thing they're all tattered or worn out. It just means that they're trying to get rid of it because they need to put something else in the space that is taking up. You understand? And a lot of the times, like I tell you, that's where my shopping starts. I didn't start with that for this. But if I waited a little bit longer, somebody would have buy this. I couldn't wait for the sketch to sell.
I love this dress. I love that it's so simple. That you can just wear anything, accessorize it any which way you want, and it could look different every single time you wear it.
So I wear this dress more often than they hear me. I don't want anyone to judge me. This is Morning Manners. The number on the screen is the number that you can send your text into. Cindy is going to be sitting in with me this morning, helping me out with some matters. So if anything that matter to you this morning, matter to us. The number again is on the screen. Cindy, you have any matter?
No.
That seems truthful. It seems like you have matter, but you don't want to tell me.
No, I definitely don't have no matters. None at all.
None?
No matters. Very simplistic. Life, very simple.
Cindy, how old are you?
I'm 27.
27? You don't look 27. Let's start with that. Do you have any children? Are you married?
None.
None of those things.
Yeah.
Are you in a relationship?
No.
Oh, good. How does a 27-year-old productive woman manage to keep herself to herself in this day and age? And you're not ugly. So if you're ugly, I say, well, maybe. But no, you're not ugly. You got a job. You look decent. You know. You have personality. What's up with that?
I think I'm just too busy right now and focused on myself and future plans, future goals. And I feel like maybe this is not the best time for distractions.
You know, I like that. I like the fact that you are focused on you. But there are a lot of other people that are too busy focusing on them, that they lose the opportunity to focus on them. How important is it for you to be focused on you at this stage in your life?
Well, this is a stage where most of, I watch a lot of TED Talks, guilty. So I've been learning that this is a stage in your life where a lot of your personal development happens. A lot of the becoming an adult happens at this stage in your life. A lot of people feel like, you know what, because they don't have everything together at 25, that life is over for them. But really, this is the time that you're building your future. So that's why I want to stay focused during this time, because it's very crucial to the rest of my life.
You have said a mouthful. A lot of people think that when they're 27, they're already adult. They don't know what they're doing. They don't. They're women, you know? And you essentially have said that they're just developing into that womanhood. Were you always this focused and this driven?
No, definitely not. I would say in the past 3 years or so is when I started to really realize that, you know what? I have a lot that I need to work on. I at 25, I probably had a little breakdown, a mental breakdown, because I did think that, you know what? What am I doing with my life? Where am I right now? I'm nowhere that I pictured that I would be when I was like 12 and I was thinking about who I was going to be when I was 25. So I started to cry. I was so sad. And I was like, you know what? It's okay. I watched some videos online and, you know what? I'm not the only one that feels this way. But this is the time to set certain things in place for myself for later on. And so that's why I decided to become more focused and to actually work on myself internally as well, mentally, because that has a lot to do with how successful you're going to be.
What brought you to this point? Because when most people are 25, they don't get to, they feel like they don't do all their work. You understand? No, I mean, but I realize that some people are in their 40s and they're where you are now because they delayed the process. But what was your turning point?
I think it's probably because I, for personal reasons, I don't have a lot of people in my life to guide me. Like, a lot of people have their parents and, you know, different mentors and all of this, and I really don't have that for me. So at some point I was like, okay, so where do I get guidance from? So I looked at the internet and the internet says, look at yourself. And so I'm like, okay, but who am I? And I was lost. I didn't really know who I was. And spending more time with yourself, you really get to find out who you are, what your likes are, what things you don't like, what things you're not going to tolerate, what things you're okay with or to compromise on. And that, to me, is what a lot of people need to be focusing on right now.
Who would have thought that when I came in here this morning, I figured me and Cindy, we were on the talk about clothes, hairstyle, because Cindy definitely dressed me 90% of the time, right? And what is the guy's name that you have in its store?
Wendell.
Between Cindy and Wendell, then point out where I'm supposed to look like today or tomorrow or whenever, right? Sometimes I listen to them, sometimes I don't listen to them. Sometimes I just come in and I want a romper and I want a solid romper and okay what they say, and now they get nothing else today. But then some days they put me in something like this. And I ain't got no choice but to wear it, so I wear it. But I say that to say that when we see people, we don't understand their growth.
That's
and their persona a lot of times. And I like the fact that you seek and still continue to seek your own betterment.
Mm-hmm.
I think a lot of people can learn from you. A lot of people misuse and waste the internet. You have capitalized on what is there. Instead of you the Facebook all the time, you to read something. How often do you go to the internet, and what are some of the things you look for and who on the internet?
Like I said, I listen to a lot of TED Talks. Sometimes it's what's playing in my headphones while I'm designing something, because I do a lot of the marketing. Well, I work in the marketing department for Pink Boutique, so I'm always designing something, or I do a lot of what you do. So I need to be creative, but I also need to be focused. So sometimes I'm listening to that, sometimes listening to music. But when I'm just scouring the internet for something to learn from, I just go YouTube. I just go Google. Sometimes something pops in my mind, an idea pops in my mind, and I just need to know the answer to it. And instead of asking someone, why not just ask the internet? The internet always knows.
Cindy, you're onto something. You definitely are onto something, because it's true. A lot of people, or a lot of young and old people, they don't have the people in their life that is equipped with the information they need.
Mm-hmm.
And because they go to people that are ill-equipped, they get wrong answers. And when they get wrong answers, their life spiral out of control. It's good to see that you have kept yourself in order. You rope yourself back in, like you say in a Creole. And you're doing good. Congratulations, and continue keeping it up.
Thank you very much.
Now that we get all of that, the history out of the way, who better for us the matters to than one Galway, self-motivated, and the seek betterment for herself. You know, she don't want... Definitely one star girl at the moment, I call it today. So now that we have gotten that out the way, you think it's time to jump in at some... You're ready for them? You know, there's this guy called Eckhart Tolle. I always speak about Eckhart Tolle. Do you listen to Eckhart Tolle or any of his...
No, I can't say I've heard of Eckhart Tolle.
Well, today or tomorrow when you get a chance, listen. Eckhart Tolle really works for me. Eckhart Tolle is one of the people that his voice for me is soothing. And when there's audiobooks from Eckhart Tolle, they speak to your soul.
Yes.
And once you find something that speaks to your soul and quiets you, it helps to shape you in a more positive way. Not that I think you need that, but I think a lot of us need that. I listen to him. I mean, some Sundays you come to my house, you can't find me.
Mm-hmm.
And me and Eckhart Tolle lock up in my room. And we spending Sunday together, me here a cup of tea. Or 3 cup of tea, depending on how I feel.
Isn't that just the best? Like, that's a part of being single that a lot of people don't realize. Like, it's like the nicest feeling ever to just be by yourself and to just be learning something and enjoying something else that you like, even something as small as a cup of tea.
That is sweetest feeling.
And you feel happy, genuinely happy.
You feel clean. Now, a clean, peaceful feeling. So whenever you feel like you're going out of control, I encourage you to watch Morning Matters. But Morning Matters is not as accessible all the time as a lot of these other things. And one of these other things, I definitely recommend Eckhart Tolle. Once you get introduced to him, he will impact your life in a positive way. He will change your life forever. This is Morning Matters. The number on the screen, use it. Let's jump into somebody's matter since we don't have no real matters right now. But you know what, listen, as the day progress, we discuss our matters in different ways. Mm-hmm. I like the fact, I like showing the human side of people. Mm-hmm. And I thank you for opening up to yourself so that they can see the human in you. Because when people listen to you on Morning Matters, they not only see the marketing rep from Pink, they see a person.
Yeah, I totally agree. And I love connecting with people. I'm a people like person. I've been in different forms of work involving tourism, you know, sales. I've done different things that involve just talking to people and getting to know them. And I find that I connect with them better when I can find common ground with them.
This is Morning Matters, and the number is on the screen, and now the matter says, I have my son. His father isn't in his life for some time now. One day I got a call that he was taking my son, that he wants to take my son to meet his other woman. I am not sure if this is the time and place. Should I allow him?
Well, I don't have kids, so I don't know, but I would assume that after a certain period of time, that's normal, isn't it? I would think it's normal. What do you say? It depends on how long he's been with the other woman, I guess. Like if she's a serious person in his life, maybe they're thinking about moving in together or whatever. Then maybe he wants to step up and be more of a dad. Maybe he's trying to show this new woman that he's serious about different things in his life. And perhaps this is a step in the right direction for him. Depends on the whole situation.
I agree with you. I think that he needs to be... See, when a man or a woman comes to spend time with his or her child, unless they're physically going to harm them, it is an experience for the child. So if this man has been absent from the child's life and now he show up and he say, look, little John, I want you to go and meet my friend Cindy or my girlfriend Cindy or what, however he chooses to refer to the other person, I would let him go because that will be their memory, the son and the father memory. And even if the woman doesn't last in their life, it is a memory for him and his father to have. It is nothing for you to control. So you need to allow your child enough, in my opinion, experience with his other parent. As parents, I believe our intentions are always good. And if you don't, I mean, besides being malicious, spiteful, and jealous, what is the problem?
I agree. It's if it's just you feel that you don't want your son around whoever this other person is because you don't like her, even though you may not even know who she is, then no, you probably need to get over that.
Yes, don't try to control too much. The control really should be given to the parent that has the physical custody in that moment, unless, of course, it is a dangerous situation. No danger, no problem.
I think in this case, she probably feels this way because, like she said, he hasn't been in his life for a while, and then now all of a sudden he shows up and he wants to introduce the child to somebody else.
He ready?
Yeah, that's what I think. I think that it might be a step in the right direction, but you know what? If it doesn't go well, I'm sure the son will say something.
But not only that, generally as well, people, generally people, and I will say that includes potential step-parent, they love children. People love children. So this is just an opportunity for this child to be exposed to someone else that could possibly love him.
I agree. And there has been cases with kids who've been raised by both sides of the family, co-parenting. By both sides, the mom and the new stepdad and the dad and the new stepmom, and everybody loves the child. All the child gets is four people to love that one person.
I have a child that is exactly in that same position. Good morning. What can I do about my husband who doesn't discipline his children? We, who are my stepchildren, but gets mad when I do so, whilst my children get all the discipline. So it is a blended family that they have, where the father doesn't discipline his children. She has children, but everybody disciplines her children.
Even the stepdad, mm-hmm. But he don't discipline his children. That seems like a double standard.
This is what happens when you don't blend the family well. If you come into this home, we are no longer you that this one set up and you that this one set up. We that the parents are under the picnic, straight across the board. There's no my child, your, these are our children. And when you don't treat the children as our children, make them, you know, blend them correct, that when the problem comes, because you can't come as the wife with your two boys, and me as the husband with my two boys and my two girls, and then they go on different set of rules. In at this house, we don't have family. I are the woman, you are the man, and these are our children. So for that to stop, you need to have one set of rules for all the children. And the people that will decide that one set of rules would be you two. So you two need to sit back and come together as the head of this home and stop the separation. The separation starts because you two are not clear in your position. You understand? So when you go up on the road, you know, they say, well, this is Tom Jones' son. This is my son, especially if you do everything for her. This is my son. This is my son just as much as it is your son, especially if he little and he live under my roof and I the feeder and I the mighty little. So he will be treated with the same rules as my child. And then you need to come up with a measure of discipline for all the children and administer it.
I agree. I completely agree. And I have nothing to add.
Okay. I have been with my common-law for the past 5 years and have a 9-month-old baby boy with him. When I was pregnant, he used to do many things for me. For example, he used to go, I guess supposed to be to me. He used to go sleep with other women and he would come home and try to hit me. From since our son was born, he changed. Do you think it will remain that way? Or if not, should I stay for the sake of the baby?
I think you should go for it.
I will take that opportunity. When the man made a bad pyre, made a sleep out, made the attempt to hit you, you stay with him. Now we come back, you know, the child, none of them thing. When the baby born, the man say, you know what? I want to shape up before they have to ship me out. Now that he's shaping up is when you have the problem. You want to know if he's going to change. You should have wanted to know if he was going to change before he changed. Now he changed into good. Celebrate it. Keep it going. If he was getting progressively worse, I could understand. If you were to leave him, you should have left him long time when he's batting on you. No, he stopped bad. He trying to show up for the job. I don't think that you should abandon the ship when it's just a catch winning at the sail.
I think that, yes, maybe she should give it a shot since he's changed, and that's probably all she wanted from the beginning. If he's doing exactly what you wanted, then see how it goes. I guess if he relapses, then, you know, then maybe that's the next time to think, okay, maybe I should leave.
I think it's going well. Celebrate it. You're fair. Do not live your life based on fear. Live your life based on faith and common sense. You see where it is going now. Adapt to it. On that note, we're going to take a break and be back.
Taste of pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
100% pure and natural. Share the juice with your family and your neighbors. And you can find them in so many flavors.
Like grapefruit, orange, hey! Orange pineapple, fruit punch, apple, hey! And pineapple.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
100%
preservatives, no additives, pure fresh orange, that is how real it is.
Buy one, open it, and drink it, so nice.
Gimme, the Caribbean pride.
100% pure and natural.
Of all the colors in the world, orange is perhaps the most exciting, distinctive, and vibrant color there is. Just like the Orange Gallery. But what makes the Orange Gallery outstanding is what's inside.
A huge collection of breathtaking wood carvings and a spectacular display of home decor accessories and magnificent gift items. Browse a fabulous selection of furniture from chairs to entertainment centers. And wait till you see the Orange Gallery's breathtaking selection of jewelry for every occasion and every person, from casual to dressy bracelets and earrings to great items for men, including a spectacular choice of handmade knives. Then, when you've shopped till you're ready to drop, drop in to the Orange Gallery's fabulous restaurant and recharge for the rest of your Orange expedition. The Orange Gallery. Beautiful, unique, exquisite.
Have an idea for the building of a structure and not sure exactly what you want or how to go about achieving it? Then worry no more. Let the pros at Remen Associates get it done for you. At Remen Associates, we have trained professionals that can assist you in the designing, engineering, and construction of the building of your choice. At Remen Associates, we bring your ideas to life. Call Remen Associates at 615-6200 or visit them at 3/4 miles on the Iguana Creek Road in the Spanish Lookout.
Si tu perro es de raza, raza grande o pequeña, dale Rambocan, Rambocan. Si es delgado o robusto, pelo largo, pelo corto, dale Rambocan, Rambocan. Rambocan en su presentación para adultos
o cachorros.
Dale Rambocan
para que tu perro tenga piel sana y pelo brillante, huesos y dientes fuertes, músculos resistentes y mejor digestión. Dale lo mejor.
Dale Rambocan,
salud y vigor para tu perro.
Looking for quality and affordable fashion? The It Store, where you can shop fashion for less. We have clothing for the entire family and quality that fits your budget. The number one store in town. Find kids, men, and women apparel for all occasions. We are located at the number one Queen Street, Belize City. Call us at 223-1552. Remember to like us on Facebook. The It Store. Find it, love it, buy it for less.
At Westrack Belize City, we are looking to help you save both your time and money. We've also improved our stock levels to ensure we have everything you might need for your automotive or agricultural needs. Additionally, Westrack has added heavy-duty and industrial parts to keep your trucks and equipment running. At Westrack Belize City, we understand that your time is important, so we want to bring our services to you at your convenience. Now you can simply send us a message on WhatsApp or Facebook, and we will be right there to help with any questions you may have.
Hello, and welcome to A&R.
With a wide variety of household items, party supplies, and gift ideas to choose from, A&R is definitely the shopping spot of choice for you. We have loads of kitchen appliances such as freezers, washers, refrigerators, pots, pans, and other items including stationery, school bags, swimming pools, sturdy plastic chairs, and toys for boys and girls. Check out A&R at any of our many locations in San Pedro, Orange Walk, Cayo, and Belize City. At A&R, we strive to provide all your shopping needs under one roof.
Third and final segment of Morning Matters right here from Pink Boutique in Belize City. Sydney, how did it go?
It did go good. I think the show did go good so far.
You enjoy it?
Yeah.
Sydney, do you have siblings or are you an only child?
No, I have 3 brothers. No sisters.
Older, younger?
1 older, 2 younger.
So what is it like being brought up as an only girl?
Well, you know what? Most people would... I always got people saying that, oh my gosh, they must treat you like a little princess. That was never the case. So my parents made sure that there was no favoritism going on. But I did get my own room, so that was good. Like when you know, we were moving around and anybody had to share a room, it was never me. Because I'm the only girl.
See, there's some perks in that because they don't want for the princess part come in. Let's jump into another matter. Ay. My wife of 6 years has male friend that I am suspecting something is happening with them. I asked her and she said no. I told her I am going to approach him about my suspicions. She told me if I do that, then she'll break up with me and end our marriage. What am I to think?
Well, I don't know. I think that's up to... I think they need to communicate better and she needs to be a little bit more transparent about who this friend is. And I feel that if you're going to have a male friend, this friend also needs to be friend with the husband. If it's your husband, how are you having a friend that you go and hang out with of the opposite sex that your husband never hangs out with too? I feel like, I don't know, I feel like it's inappropriate to hang out alone with another person of the opposite sex, especially if you're married.
I hear you. I don't completely agree with everything that you said. I think that it is inappropriate to have a friend that your husband is not able to communicate with, right? So if I have a husband and I have a male friend and my husband say, look, I feel like you and Tom Jones having something, it is my duty to assure my husband, and look, man, Tom Jones and I have nothing. Whenever we go, you can come, or I will include my husband in this circle. But I don't think it is appropriate for my husband to ask me to stop being this person's friend, especially if we were friends prior. I would say I would allow all openness and access to my husband. So if he wants to go ask Tom Jones something, then only he will only look like a fool in front of Tom Jones, because Tom Jones know he crazy because nothing happening with us. The minute I prevent him from having access to Tom Jones, there must be some reason for that. Mm-hmm. There has to be some reason for it, because my first priority should be him and I. And once that priority is shifted, then something is missing.
I do think it's a little bit extreme that she would say that she would end the entire marriage if he asked him about it. That's a big red flag. That's a big red flag. Because if there was really nothing going on, she wouldn't care if he asked.
She would have just said, why Tom Jones, my husband, simple. You know, he know he come in here to ask you some foolishness. Please forgive him. Just answer him off. But I mean, she might feel embarrassed, but she wouldn't say, I'm going to left you for that. But at the end of the day, where there is no trust, there is no love. So, in my mind. So if you can't trust the person, then might as well you're not with them. Simply because today I want to think about Tom Jones. Tomorrow I want to think about James. The next day I want to think about Lucas. Every day I will be thinking about somebody else because I don't trust you. And the problem wouldn't be all of those men. The problem would be you. Because it's you I'm married to. You understand? So if you, the man, having this problem, I would rethink my position. This can't be so much of a big deal that if you approach him, if she leaves you for that, she wanted to leave you a long time.
Agreed.
I was just wondering. I have been in a relationship for over 10 years, and one day my boyfriend decided to leave me for a younger woman. And after 7 months, he is trying to win me back, and I have already moved on. And now he sees me with my new boyfriend, and now he is jealous and wants me back. What am I to do?
I don't know. I think that's, if he left you, then I don't know. I guess that now he's realizing what he had and what he lost, or maybe whatever he was trying to go get out there didn't pan out. And I think it depends on her and whether she's happy in this new relationship. If she's happy in a new relationship, then she should stay in a new relationship despite what he feels, because he's the one that threw her away, so to speak, if he's the one that broke up with her. But maybe all they needed in the first place was a little bit of a break to, I don't know. I really don't know this one.
Cindy, you ever had a...
I never had a
relationship. Purse? No, listen. You ever had a purse that... Maybe you look in your closet and you have 4 purses. This really the one thing that happened to me. And then this one day, my sister come to the house, right? And I say, no, thank you, on this purse. I never use this purse, I'm going to give on this purse. I have this purse for a while. Nice looking purse. So now, ever so often I see my sister rock this purse, right? And I just say, I want this purse back. You know, my mind, right? Because this is a nice purse. I should have kept this purse. I never see the value of the purse till I give it away. But possibly when I get back the purse, unless I get it to put it back on the shelf, you know.
Yeah.
And now I use it again.
Maybe the purse is not your style. And that's why you give it away and that's somebody else's style. And you sit in and use it in a the whatever way how they are. And they like it. And it's the fact that they like it make you like it.
That's exactly what happened to you if you go back. They take you for put you right back on the shelf when they take you off in the first place. The problem is not the man that you left, and it's not the man you have. It's the mind that you have for yourself. You know, confident in your position. If somebody leaves you, regardless of what is the reason that they left you for, they left, you should not be thinking about going back to them, because I tell you, they're going to treat you like the purse. They want maybe wear your foot today because I get back the purse. Because I'm going to see the people and wear the purse with Batty Rider and belly out clothes, right? Like, so I want to wear it just like that. When I realize that Batty Rider is not my style, and definitely not belly out. I mean, really. You understand? Mm-hmm. So the purse don't really work for me. The same way that man don't really work for you. After 10 years, he move on and he has somebody else. And now he wants you back after 7 months. He don't want you back because nothing changed. He wants you back because he's seeing you from a different angle. It is his fault that he never see you in that angle in the first place. Keep it pushing.
I agree. I can't even dispute any of that logic. All it sounds like it makes a lot of sense.
Okie dokie. I think I'll put this one in the short version. Okay. I am 40. I didn't read the text in the middle. She started with a long text, so I'm going to take the two texts.
Okay.
Okay, I'll start. I want reading in the middle, same way then. I am 40 years old and I am dating somebody that is 18 years older than me. So 58. Do you think that is right?
I don't see the problem in that.
Me neither.
She's 40. I feel that I'm a big believer in that after a certain point, you go on mental maturity or just maturity on a whole, and what that person has to bring to the table, and at some point age does not matter. That's just how I feel.
Right at that point, right there. When you become 40, you could date anybody. Because you
young
are
or older.
Young or older in between. Especially once they're not a minor, you can date them. Why? Mm-hmm. But no, I can't take that back. Once you're a 40-year-old woman, you could date any man within a certain age range to the lower, and any man older than you. So if the man 1 year or 20 years older than you, you can date him at the age of 40 in my mind. Now, you can also date a boy that's 20, but you're looking for fire. That will bring your problem. Generally, that will bring your problem. But at 40, you're supposed to be sensible enough to know what you're working with. So if you want a 20-year-old boy and you're just going for the ride, know that you're just going for the ride. Because at 25, his mind will change. He don't want no old woman.
Yeah.
Right now, you want a young boy. But in the next 5 years, you can't deal with this 25-year-old because he went up on a different level most of the time. Sometimes you find yourself a young old boy or old young boy and it works out. But generally, if the man 58 and you 40 and everything works, I don't see the problem there. None at all. But you know what I have to say, Cindy? From the mere fact she did question it, she not comfortable with it.
Yeah, I think that socially or maybe people around her aren't comfortable with it, and that's why she might be questioning it now.
Well, if I had my 58 year old man and I 40, I taking him down Albert Street because he's my man. And not only that, it is, you can't live your life based on other people's opinion, because if you get a boy that's 40, they're gonna have a problem with it. If you get a boy that's 1 inch shorter than you, they'll have a problem with it. If you get a boy that's 1 inch wider than you, they'll have a problem with it. They will have a problem all the way. The problem is if you have a problem. If you don't have a problem, then there is no problem.
Yeah.
You understand? I say you live your life based on principles and common sense and morals. Principles will cause you to live morally. But you have to put some common sense into it. If it work for you, then it work. If it don't work for you, not because it work for the neighbor, mean it work. If it will not work for you, it don't work. And some of the things that work for you will not work for them. Because you're not them.
Yep.
You are you. So let me do one more. My girlfriend left me for another man. What should I do? What you could do?
Yeah.
Not like if your puppy get away. It gone. Unless somebody bring him back. In this case, you don't want nobody bring him back. You don't want you find a way back. And if you find a way back, then you have something to think about because there's no puppy. But if he gone, he gone.
I think that you should generally lose interest in anybody that's not interested in you.
Respect yourself enough to know that if they don't respect you or value you, you should treat them with the same courtesy.
Mm-hmm. And definitely leaving is a sign that I just wasn't interested in being with you. So, time to move on. Life goes on. You might find somebody even better.
Not one of that. You see, me, I am not one of these mannequins in here where everybody could come and touch up and care home and buy it. So today they want it, next day they don't want it, they stuff and buy and sell the leaves because then they're ready to get rid of it. We are human beings with brains. We have to make choices and be able to stick to them. That's just it, you know. We can't let... A lot of times I think what happens in this is that the boy comes in and says, oh my God, I still love you, you look so pretty, la 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 la. You feel like you need to go. No, you don't need to go. 10 men come and sell it a day. So if they come sell it every day, 10 men a day, what will happen to you? No, you don't have to write. You don't need that. People, especially women, need to realize that not because the boy court them or make advances on them, they have to yield. That doesn't man job for chase. That your job for decide. Who won't catch you? You are the prize. You are the prize. And when, how the prize situation runs in the way I always say, right? When the prize, you come to work Monday, right? And you have to work 1 week or 2 weeks before you get paid.
Two.
When you come to work the first of the month, surely not say, oh, I think Cindy will work for the next 14 days, so make a pay now. You have to put in the work first. A lot of the women, they see the man today, they want to give him the prize right away because they think he under wrong. So he can get the prize before he run the race. No way in the world you get the prize before you run the race. Give the man the chance to run the race.
That's not what I want anyways.
All I want
chase.
But that ain't job. But like if you take away the chase, you take away the manhood from the man. I live in this neighborhood where when I drive out in the morning, all the dogs run behind me. When I stop my vehicle, they lose all enjoy. You know why? Because they're not for chase. So yes. I wait for the next car now.
Mm.
Be the car with them chase. And whenever you're ready for slow down, you pick up the puppy where you want. You would have chosen him. But you like chasing. Morning Matters is winding down. Anything you'd like to leave us with?
Shop at all the pink stores. A lot of people come into one pink and say, you know, the one thing in all the stores. This is true. There's a lot of the same things in all the stores because we send merchandise to all our stores. But there's different people in different places that buy different things. So we also think about that when we send our goods and merchandise to different stores. So, for example, now there's a second pink boutique in Belize City. That doesn't mean you stop shopping at the other pink boutique either, because that other store is actually bigger than this one. So do the math. There's more things over there. There's more sizes over there. And so if you don't find something in one, then check the next one. Maybe we have what you're looking for.
Cindy, thank you for stopping in this morning with us. Thank you for sharing any thoughts you'd like to leave us with.
Definitely, I've been seeing this a lot. A lot of people are advocating for self-love. A lot of people out here are looking for love in other people, but they have not learned to love themselves first, and that's why a lot of their relationships fail. Because it's two people that are looking for love in the next person. And honestly, if you love yourself first, you'll know exactly what's right for you. You'll know exactly what's not. And you won't be scared to walk away if you're in a situation that's not right for you, because you know that being alone is not so bad. It's really not so bad, especially when you love yourself.
Cindy, thank you guys. Until next time, we encourage you to take care of yourselves and each other. This is Rhonda along with
Cindy Katus.
Saying goodbye.
Taste of pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
Gimme, me Caribbean pride.
100% pure and natural.
Share the juice with your family and your neighbors. And you can find them in so many flavors.
Like grapefruit, orange.
perhaps the most exciting, distinctive, and vibrant color there is. Just like the Orange Gallery. But what makes the Orange Gallery outstanding is what's inside. A huge collection of breathtaking wood carvings and a spectacular display of home decor accessories and magnificent gift items. Browse a fabulous selection of furniture, from chairs to entertainment centers. And wait till you see the Orange Gallery's breathtaking selection of jewelry for every occasion and every person, from casual to dressy bracelets and earrings to great items for men, including a spectacular choice of handmade knives. Then, when you've shopped till you're ready to drop, drop in to the Orange Gallery's fabulous restaurant and recharge for the rest of your orange expedition. The Orange Gallery. Beautiful. Unique. Exquisite.
Have an idea for the building of a structure and not sure exactly what you want or how to go about achieving it? Then worry no more. Let the pros at Remen Associates get it done for you. At Remen Associates, we have trained professionals that can assist you in the designing, engineering, and construction of the building of your choice. At Remen Associates, we bring your ideas to life. Call Remen Associates at 615-6200 or visit them at 3/4 miles on the Iguana Creek Road in the Spanish Lookout.
Si tu perro es de raza, raza grande o pequeña, dale un Rambocan, Rambocan. Si es delgado o robusto, pelo largo, pelo corto, dale un Rambocan, Rambocan. Rambocan en su presentación para adultos
o cachorros.
Dale Rambocan
para que tu perro tenga piel sana y pelo brillante, huesos y dientes fuertes, músculos resistentes y mejor digestión. Dale lo mejor.
Dale Rambocan.
Salud y vigor para tu perro.
Looking for quality and affordable fashion? The It Store, where you can shop fashion for less. We have clothing for the entire family and quality that fits your budget. The number one store in town. Find kids, men, and women apparel for all occasions. We are located at the number one Queen Street, Belize City. Call us at 223-1552. Remember to like us on Facebook. The It Store. Find it, love it, buy it for less.
At WestTrak Belize City, we are looking to help you save both your time and money. We've also improved our stock levels to ensure we have everything you might need for your automotive or agricultural needs. Additionally, WestTrak has added heavy-duty and industrial parts to keep your trucks and equipment running. At WestTrak Belize City, we understand that your time is important, so we want to bring our services to you at your convenience. Now you can simply send us a message on WhatsApp or Facebook, and we will be right there to help with any questions you may have.
Hello and welcome to A&R.
With a wide variety of household items, party supplies, and gift ideas to choose from, A&R is definitely the shopping spot of choice for you. We have loads of kitchen appliances such as freezers, washers, refrigerators, pots, pans, and other items including stationery, school bags, swimming pools, sturdy plastic chairs, and toys for boys and girls. Check out A&R at any of our many locations in San Pedro, Orange Walk, Cayo, and Belize City. At A&R, we strive to provide all your shopping needs under one roof.